Before the 470 top 10 head out to the centre course, let's catch up with the front runners in the pit lane.
Pressure is something that's made up in your own head, you know what I mean, Stuart? You know, we worked hard for this regatta and we're in a good, great position and, you know, we're just grateful for the opportunity and excited more than anything else to go out there and tear it up in front of the crowd.
And that is the start. It's a great start by Croatia there, heading off towards the left-hand side.
Wow, and Luke and Stu have tacked away. They're hopefully seeing some breeze out on the right-hand side there. The other thing you'll notice is that the O-flag's flying on the committee boat right now, and that's an open pumping rule.
So the British team saw a big wind shift. They weren't following the pack in towards the wall, which is usually pay. That's Luke Patience and Stuart Bithell. The likely outcome for them is a silver medal, but you can't do better than be at the front of the fleet. Well, here we go, coming in towards the top mark. It is the pair that your eyes are on. Luke Patience and Stuart Bithell not yet got their Olympic place decided. Extraordinary battle in this class, including the double Olympic silver medalist Nick Rogers. Beltram Page up to sixth. Start getting the glasses out. This gate here, you choose either one of the two marks. There's no surprise where most of the boats are going. They're heading to the right-hand side, and as I say that, the French decide to go.
Yeah, the only option they had there, really. There's so many boats to the left-hand side of them, they've got to take this other mark.
From Great Britain's perspective, Luke Patience and Stuart Bithell have gone to the left-hand side of the track. The rest of the fleet in their wake. And coming up to fourth, there's no need to do that, but they may as well. Belcher and Page, the men heading for a world title. That crew there, as low down as he can, hand behind the head, maximum leverage, his arm behind his head.
He's almost trying to make it look casual, isn't he?
Luke Patience and Stuart Bithell approaching this mark, a team who started so well and haven't looked back. Slight shift in the wind, slightly struggling to go around this top mark. No need to tack. Around we go. Spinnaker up, little pump of the sail. And behind them, the Greek combination come into the mark. There's real distance now between the British team and the rest of the pack heading in. The Australians, though, are gently marching their way up through the fleet. And look at that, there's the world champion in waiting from Australia. Patience and Bithell leading the race, heading for silver. And bronze, well, at the moment it says Snow and Saunders, but in that last picture it was looking very much like Sima Fantella and Igor Marinich.
No, basically only four boats in this race that can actually come away with any silverware at all. And, you know, we're looking now, it looks reasonably confident that the Aussies have got that wrapped up. I mean, they're pumping that sail super hard there, working their way down the run. Even though they think they've got it wrapped up, you can't take your eye off, can you? You've just got to keep working max out the whole way.
Luke Patience can't wait to the end of this race.
I think the lads will be enjoying themselves now, actually. You know, they're looking more and more comfy. Their speed is clearly good. They're extending away from the fleet, being able to pick and choose where they put themselves on the racetrack.
But the Australian team, I think perhaps the part of their tactic here was on that first leg. Let's just quite a few boats around, stay out of trouble, get into our groove and sail our own race, just see where we finish.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you know, they maybe had some worrying moments at the top end of that first beat where Luke and Stuart extended and were leading and they were kind of back in sort of 8 and 9, but, you know, then it's not their first time, is it? And they'll be confident of their speed and knowing what they had to do. Just anything other than 10th was going to secure them a gold medal, and that would be easy enough for them, I'm sure. You know, look at the distance. The next team hasn't even rounded the final mark yet, and the lads for life are pretty much across the finish line. Here they come.
That is a silver medal for the British team. Yeah. This is the moment that started with expectation. Yeah. Has been completed. Victory for Australia. They are the world champions in the 470. They've made it look easy from the beginning. A big smile there on the face of both Matthew Belcher and Malcolm Page.
And this is the way the medals went. Croatia in bronze, Great Britain silver, Australia, the hometown heroes Belcher and Page get gold. The international jury played a major role in the Finn class yesterday by disqualifying four-time Olympic medalist Ben Ainslie in race 9. Ainslie was leading the regatta overall, but the jury decided that an outburst after the finish involving a media boat contravened the rarely used Rule 69 in sailing for behaviour. Ainsley is out of the top 10, leaving the door open for PJ Posma from the Netherlands and Giles Scott from Britain to duke it out for the world title.
Really tricky race and very tight off the start line with that wall. You know, it'll be tight, all to play for.
The organisers are getting good value out of that Perth sign. Let's head to the Finn Park before they launch into their medal race.
Well, I've got PJ 3 points behind and Ed 9. They're the only two that can beat me. So that means I need to stay within one place of PJ and four of Ed.
That's the start. Oh, second gun. Someone was over the line. That is British sailor, top of pitcher. And Ed Wright, number 11 there, the defending champion, heading back for two British sailing, a very poor start. So this is PJ Posma from Holland, second at the start of this race, heads downwind. Hawk Christensen from Denmark is just behind. And Giles Scott, the overall leader, is in third position. Posma can get into the lead, he has. That was his plan. Giles Scott third. Posma would win. At the moment, that title is heading to the Netherlands. Ahead, this will tell us the story so far, and it's a story that will please Giles Scott, but there's no means certain, because second, Hawk Christensen, there doesn't need to be much of a wind shift for him to slide into the place. And actually, that picture now is showing Scott in third, and if it stays like that, the world title goes to the Netherlands. Look at the right of the screen. There he comes, and that's exactly what Posma wants. Posma rounds the mark. Big rock, it's going to be very energetic. The fitness is going to come in. We talked about fitness with the boards. You just watch what's coming up now. Second, Denmark. Denmark doing the Netherlands a favour now, keeping Giles Scott off first position. So Scott is in third. What can he do? And this, at the moment, the story is as much about the Danish sailor as PJ Posma, and when the helicopter shot's looking down at him, watching that technique now, middle of the boat, pull, now like that. And you can see, as he pulls, you can see more white water around the boat accelerates. Coming down to the bottom mark for the second time, PJ Posma at the moment is still on target for a world championship title, because the Danish sailor, Hoog Christensen, is ahead of Giles Scott from Great Britain. But if Scott can get past the Danish sailor, it will change the game. And the Danish sailor tacks. I can hear the cheers from the commentary box. Here comes Giles Scott. Let's see the order as they shuffle around the top markets. World title is now heading to the Netherlands. Giles Scott tacks. Posma rounds the top mark. He's defended his lead. Christensen second, Giles Scott third. This is the race to the finish. This is Giles Scott. Ahead of him, Hawk Christensen from Denmark. He's running out of runway and a big overtaking move there from Giles Scott. He got that right. Do that again, he'll go past. He's done it again. Giles Scott overtakes. Well, he's in a momentum now. Giles Scott got the momentum, sailed straight past. He's still going. And look at that, from behind him to a 21-metre advantage. Balance of power, Great Britain. Giles Scott holds the world title at the moment. Posma now is 20 metres away in a dying wind. Giles Scott behind is going to finish the championship of his life. He looks behind. The story is you were second. And the story is about to cross the line. This is Giles Scott. He looks under the boom. He says thank you. What must he be thinking? Victory for the British sailor. A little thumbs up, a twinkle and a wink.
Two medals for Great Britain. Giles Scott secures the gold. Peter Jan Posma gets the silver and Ed Wright bronze.
That race was so hectic. It's kind of all a bit of a shock if I'm honest. But yeah, I suppose I won, didn't I?
That's it. That's his moment. Giles Scott is the world champion.